We will now begin recording the interview with Georgina Samet. The recording takes place on the 7th of April 2017 and at Radio Cardiff. The volunteers present are Kaylee Williams and Lara Taffer, and this recording is being collected as an oral history and will be part of the Chronicle Project, a project led by VCS Cymru and funded by the Heritage Lottery Fund. Georgina, would you introduce yourself, please?
Hello, I'm Georgina Samet. I present the No Frills Breakfast Show on Radio Cardiff 98.7 FM. I expect you can hear that I haven't got a very strong Welsh accent. That's because I'm English. I come from Birmingham, but I've lived in Wales for the past 46 years or so, firstly in Barmouth in mid Wales and latterly in Cardiff since 1972. I've lived in Penarth and Innispowis, as well as Aberdare and Canton and Riverside. I'm currently living in Riverside at the moment, but I do voluntary work here at Radio Cardiff.
Okay, would you mind telling us what you do here at Radio Cardiff?
Well, I do a lot of, besides causing trouble at Radio Cardiff, I also present the No Frills Breakfast Show, which is a daily weekday show from 7 o'clock in the morning till 9 o'clock every weekday, Monday to Friday. And this show is mainly based on reggae music, ska music, soul, Motown, music of black origin predominantly. It's sung by black artists usually, or written by them. But I do pop in the odd classic from white bands from England usually. And I play a lot of local artists, like Jones, Sam Jones, Black Jam Circus, loads of groups, and the Navarones and the Two Tones, all kinds of groups that are based in Cardiff.
Okay, and how did you get involved at Radio Cardiff?
Well, I've been involved with Radio Cardiff for at least 23 years, probably 24. I think in about 1981 I met John Lennie, who was the original founder of what was then Tiger Bay Radio. And then it changed from being Tiger Bay Radio to Dock of the Bay Radio, and then from Dock of the Bay Radio to Bay FM, and then Bay FM to Beats FM, and finally ended up as Radio Cardiff. But I've been with them all. I've been with them since the inception of community radio, which was developed when Cardiff Bay Development Corporation was in control of this area, and Sir Geoffrey Inkin gave us some funding to start off the community radio station. If you think back to the 80s, we had a lot of riots in areas of, with lots of poor housing conditions. We had Broadwater Farm Estate and their riots when PC Blacklock was murdered, decapitated. We had riots in Notting Hill, in Tock's death. And in order to prevent what they thought might be another flashpoint in the docks here in Cardiff, they were prepared to pump money into the area. So I was working for Cardiff City Council at the time as a special projects officer, and I thought, well, let's get some money from the Welsh office to sort of try and improve Bute Town, which might ameliorate any problems that might be occurring in the area. So I set up the Bute Town, what was it called? The Community Priority Estate Project, the Bute Town Priority Estate Project in 1981. And it was during that time when I was doing that I met John Lennie. And I used the work that I wrote, the reports that I wrote for the Welsh office, let John have a copy to use it to support his application for funding from Sir Geoffrey Inkin at the Cardiff Bay Development Corporation, and subsequent bids for funding off various other people since then. So I was right there at the very beginning. At first, my practical involvement, besides being a supporter of them through my own project, which was the Bute Town Priority Estate Project, I also became involved with them on the news level. And I used to do local news. I had a two-hour show called The Lunch Break at the beginning of Bay FM, where I used to do 2 hours of fun and interviews, which then became a shortened version to a half-hour show later on in the development of Radio Cardiff. I also did, when Cardiff was 150 years old, I made a CD for Radio Cardiff, that was called 150 Years of History, and I interviewed loads of people, 22 people, from politicians to the man who manages Cardiff Castle, to local personalities, Frank Hennessy, all sorts of people who are all involved with Cardiff. And that CD is still available in our archives of Radio Cardiff. I was the only woman on it, as usual, and there was like Paul Lyons did the backing track, which was put on after I'd done all the interviews. Also a man called, I'm trying to think of his name now, he did a couple of interviews on it, a younger man from Grangetown, but I can't remember his name now. You'll have to cut that bit out. I've remembered his name now. What was his name? I've just forgotten it again. Anyway, doesn't matter. His sister works here, Nefertiti Delgado. Nikki Delgado. I also was helped on the production of the 150 Years of Cardiff History by Nikki Delgado from Grangetown.
Wow. And do you have any fond or favourite memories of your time here?
Well, I've had so many years here. My whole life's been here, really. I mean, 45 years of my life here in Cardiff, basically. My fond memories are getting married three times in Cardiff at the registry office. They were good memories, nice parties afterwards, lots of cake. I love cake. So I enjoyed that. I've enjoyed having my daughter here with me and my son Gethin, who now lives in Australia, which is a bit sad, but he went to Fitzalan High School, got his O levels and A levels, went to Liverpool University. And then went on a backpacking trip in his 20s to Australia and never came back. So I love him very much. He's 40 now, but I do miss him terribly. But I had a great life with him when he was here. And my daughter, Samantha, is also a presenter at Radio Cardiff. And so she's sort of following in her mother's footsteps, really. And she does a wicked show on a Wednesday. So it's kind of keeping it in the family. We're all broadcasters. My son makes movies in Australia. He makes films. He's a film producer. And so it's all, we're all in the media world.
Oh, how lovely. And since you've been involved with Radio Cardiff then, have you met, or even back at the Bay in Bewtown, have you met anybody that's inspired you in your volunteering?
John Lennie, the founder member, of course, he inspired me. And Lyndon Cumberbatch, who is colloquially known as Tubby C, he's always supported me, and he's used to my bolshy ways. You know, I'm a bit of a feminist and I don't take men belittling women very lightly, and I do tend to speak my mind. So I've got friends and enemies within the organisation, but mainly friends.
That's good. And what initially motivated you to get involved with radio?
I like communicating with people. I like talking, as you can tell. It's hard to shut me up once I get going. I'm very involved in the local community of Riverside, where I live. But because of my involvement with Bewtown in the 80s, where my heart is, in the heart of Cardiff, is in the docks. That's where my soul is. Even though I physically live in Riverside, I spend a lot of my time down here. As you can see, 5 days a week, I'm always in the docks. So I know an awful lot of people from the area, and I love them, basically. There aren't many people who I don't like who live in Bewtown or Riverside or Grangetown, and I know an awful lot of people.
Okay, and what impact do you think this community radio has had on the community as a whole?
Oh, it's promoted community cohesion, definitely, because you don't get the music we play here on Radio Cardiff on any other radio station. You won't hear 11-minute long tracks of reggae. You know, we play, how many other stations play Toots and the Maytals, obscure Bob Marley tracks? You know, there is none. So we do represent the black people's music right here in Cardiff Bay, and we listened to, not just here, because of the position of our transmitter, the people of Bristol and the black community in Bristol listen to Radio Cardiff as well. So, you know, our music is spreading across the water to England. And of course now with the tuning apps and the, not just the FM radio, we've got a worldwide listenership. I have listeners, and my daughter does, from Kenya, Canada, America. We've got them in Austria. I've got a fellow DJ who works in Sweden, and we communicate a lot. I've got tribute acts in Perth in Australia who regularly come on my show by telephone link. So we link to the whole world now through the various forms of social media, which I think is divine, and spreads the music that we like playing here on Radio Cardiff, which is unique in Wales. There is no other black radio station or black music radio station in Wales, so I'm very proud to be part of that.
Well, it's definitely something to be proud of. So, bearing in mind that you've sort of been involved with the radio then since the 1980s, how would you say this community radio has changed over the years, except for its name?
Well, it's changed in a lot of ways. Now we've got many more community-based programmes like the Chronicle and the Art of Feeling Well, of Being Well. Those programmes that have come on, the Race Equality First programmes, the ones between 1:30 and 3:00, the BRG show produced and directed by my daughter, Samantha. These are all quite new initiatives that VCS have brought into the station, which kind of makes it a little bit different. The sad things to me are the people who've left, you know, the DJs and presenters who were with us in the past, who've moved on. Some of them have gone to the BBC, some of them are working, which is good because you want people to get jobs and work. But I mainly love Radio Cardiff because we're all volunteers. None of us, not a single one of us, gets paid. But we all do what we do for nothing. And I think that you can't... I'm very proud to be part of an organisation that is purely run by volunteers. And that's what Radio Cardiff is.
Wow. And are you still in contact with any of the people that have moved on to employment and things like that?
Yeah, I see some people in the street are giving me a big hug, you know. We've got... And the people I promote as well, the local singers and the local talent, they just love Radio Cardiff because Leighton Jones, who was on The Voice, he didn't get through, but Will.i.am thought he was the best singer on the show. Well, I play his music regularly. And also Sam Jones is another local singer. Faith Nelson, she was on The Voice as well. They come in to promote their tunes and let the people know that despite not winning The Voice, they're still out there and they're still producing beautiful songs. And my current favourite band is the Black Jam Circus, which is a big sounding reggae funk ska band, which is unique. And their new album to me is the best thing I've heard since Sgt. Pepper. It's so eclectic, it's so different, every track is different, you know. So it's meeting those people and trying to help them with their careers, which I find really lovely. There's some more I can drop names about. Ruel Elijah, who I met when he was like 14 with Jukebox Juniors. And I met him, a little boy, and he came in and he started singing Marvin Gaye songs. And I'm gobsmacked. Just, wow, this kid's got a voice. And now he's like 18, 19, and he's making a career for himself. Lucas J. Rowe is another one. There's so many young people. Liara, the woman who runs Jukebox Juniors, which do a lot of hip-hop dancing and street dancing throughout Britain now. They've won competitions. She's been in on my show, and I love her. I love her dad, 3J, who's another record producer. He lives in Ely. I just know an awful lot of people who are in showbiz and the media, and I'm proud to be part of their careers as well as being part of Radio Cardiff.
So in being at Radio Cardiff then, is there like a social aspect or a social life behind the scenes?
Yes, well, because I'm a DJ as well as a presenter, I tend to be the act, you know, and other people enjoy themselves when I do gigs out there in the community. And as I'm getting a little bit older, I tend to do a lot of funerals these days and be the DJ at local wakes, because we celebrate life in Bute Town rather than death. and they're real joyful events where they have a DJ and they have a dance and a jolly good drink. So I do a lot of those kinds of events, and that's my social life rolled up into the same thing. We also used to have, but we haven't done them for a few years now, which was a great social event for all the presenters and DJs here at Radio Cardiff. It was called the Radio Cardiff Awards, and we'd had Gwen McCrae, Wishing on a Star Lady, I think her name was Gwen McCrae. She came down and sang, and we've had famous bands, the Real Thing, I don't know if you remember them, they're probably a little bit before your time, from the 70s, a big Liverpool band. They come down and they be the live acts. Draytonio, another guy from Ely, he used to perform. Darren Tyson, a local lad from Llanedin, he would perform on the Radio Cardiff Awards. And then we'd get it would be just like the Oscars of Radio Cardiff. We'd have people going up, and the nominations are, and you'd have all the pictures of the people on the big screen behind the presenter who was hosting the show. And you'd see every band, and we'd have house DJs, we'd have all kinds of people winning awards, young DJs, new people. So it was a wonderful social event that we used to have at the Coal Exchange, which was derelict after we finished doing the gigs there, the awards there. But it was sort of, once we stopped being used, it deteriorated, and they had that awful plant growing in there, not weed plant, that's growing within the structure of the Coal Exchange. So it became too dangerous for people to have events. Fortunately, Mike, who is the owner of the Coal Exchange now, he wants to bring it back to life. And some of it's going to be a hotel, there's going to be studios and things like that. So we're hoping to bring the Coal Exchange back to a music venue again. And there is being mooted as we speak, a plan for another Radio Cardiff event at the Coal Exchange, featuring a lot of the artists I've mentioned earlier in this interview. So that's how we kind of, because we're in showbiz people, as presenters and DJs, we tend to have a big life out of Radio Cardiff. And so I'm early in the morning, so I don't do too many gigs late at night. I'll do afternoons and early evening gigs, or be a support act for somebody, or like the Riverside Festival, which is where I live, and it's the local festival, which this year is occurring on August the 19th in Despenser Gardens and Clare Gardens in Riverside. Come along if you can, you'll see lots of the local people there. We started organising it, we had our first meeting on Tuesday this week, and well, that's not very good for your listener. But however, we plan these things. We've got a group of people who plan it thoroughly. We have to get all the correct permissions, get the police organised, get the stage ready and stuff, and the sound systems booked and the acts booked. So it's not just music there at that festival. There's lots of stalls there. The petting zoo comes down and brings rabbits and goats and things like that. Because we're in the inner city, a lot of the children around here are of lower income families, and they don't get to the country very often, so they perhaps have never seen a cow or a goat or a chicken, even a rabbit. And so those kind of things are brought to Despenser Gardens and Clare Gardens for the children to have like a petting zoo within the community, which I find is lovely. We have owls coming, a man with lots of owls and hunting birds, hawks and things like that, eagles. He comes down regularly as well, because where else in Riverside could you see an eagle, except in the gardens of Cardiff Castle, perhaps you could see them there. But we have them right in Riverside, which we find lovely because it scares the pigeons away, which we don't like in Riverside. They're a notorious set of animals, and creatures rather, that annoy me intensely. when they sort of do their thing all over your house, it's lovely. Not lovely at all. So we got them, and as well as the Riverside Festival, I tend to be involved in a political way in the area. I've been the chairperson of the local tenants and residents group for several years, and now I'm just a committee member because a younger person, they take over. We change the chairperson every year. It tends to be women, funnily enough, on the committee, because I don't know why it is, but the women seem to live longer in Riverside than the men. I don't know whether that's the same in nationwide, but that's the way it is. So I'm involved in that. I'm a very political person, in as much as I like to do political interviews and get in. I've had Liberal Democrats, Rodney Berman. I've had Rodri Morgan, who was the head of everything in Wales, the Assembly at one time. Alan Michael, who's now the Police Commissioner, I've interviewed him several times. Kevin Brennan, the Education Minister in Westminster, I've had him on my show. So I love doing political interviews, but it's not. I have Andrew R.T. Davis, who is a big farmer, a Tory. I really enjoy talking to him because it's just, it reminds me of Winston Churchill, so I like interviewing him. Neil McAvoy from Plaid Cymru, and the lady who's in charge, I've forgotten her name, who's in charge of Plaid Cymru, and yet I used to work with her. Oh, I used to work with her, but I can't remember her name.
Was it Leanne?
Leanne Wood.
Yeah.
Yes, I used to work with Leanne Woods when I worked in probation service. So my career as a person, before I was a presenter and a volunteer, I had two careers. Well, maybe I had three careers, because after I went to university in Cardiff, that was pre-grants, when you had full grants, especially if you had children, you had a massive grant then. I was able to go and get a degree at Cardiff University in 1978 to 81. That was my degree years, and then from there I started a career in the housing department, and after I finished in housing I transferred over to probation service in Wood Street, and from then I went to be back and did a course in teaching, and I became a teacher's assistant in Kitchener Primary School, and then I developed my art skills much more fully, and I did a lot of artwork and baking in those days when I was working in Kitchener Primary School, and that was my last career, so I had three careers. That lasted about 11 years in Kitchener. I was teaching the children how to make bread for Harvest Festival. We were doing cooking. We built the first garden school, classroom in the garden in Kitchener Primary School. We were like a project that was funded by the Welsh office. Again, it was the Welsh office in those days. They funded us to start a new outdoor school, and we built a little den in the trees around the school and had classes around a campfire and everything. Things that you would think, oh, health and safety. But we pushed the boundaries, and it was when the foundation phase that's now common throughout Wales began at the school where I worked as a teacher's assistant with Fran Gluck, who was the teacher who started off the foundation course, which is now everywhere throughout Wales. So I've been involved with initiatives, and innovative initiatives I've been involved with quite a lot, because I tend to think outside the box. That is what I like to do. Still not being a conformist.
So, do you have any advice or words of inspiration, for any aspiring volunteers?
Volunteering, to me, is one of the most rewarding things a person can possibly do. It's when you're doing things because you want to, rather than because you have to. You're not doing it for any monetary reward. You're doing it because you love doing it. So, if anybody wants to get involved with all sorts of different projects in a voluntary way, it's a good grounding. Not only looks good on your CV if you want to get work in the future, but it also makes you a better person, because you are giving up your time, especially for a specific reason. And I can only say, if volunteering here at Radio Cardiff, as I told you before, we're all volunteers here, it just shows you how much we love the radio station, because we've been here for 25 years perhaps now in one form or another, and there's still some of the same people working and volunteering here. When I say working, I mean volunteering here. But volunteering is work, it's just unpaid work, and we bring a lot of joy to a lot of people, and it's very rewarding. I think the thing that it gives you most is job satisfaction. If you're doing something that you like, you feel happier in yourself, and it does show in your countenance, in the way you sit and present yourself. It does show that you're enjoying what you're doing. What more could you do? How better can you feel than being happy that you've done some good with your time in your life? So that's what I would say is my idea of volunteering and what it brings to me. And I hope it would bring that feeling to other people too. It's an extraordinarily good form of job satisfaction.
Can you finish the sentence, volunteering is ...
Well, volunteering is, to me, my life's work. Of all the work I've done paid, I've enjoyed doing my careers. As I said, I've had four careers, really, because I worked previously to work in the council housing department. I was working in all sorts of places. But to me, the job that I've done the most, the longest, stayed with the longest, has been the volunteering on Radio Cardiff. So volunteering is a lifelong opportunity for self-aggrandisement, if you know what that means, and satisfaction in your life. Brings you joy, hopefully.
Okay, well, we've asked all our questions. Was there anything else we haven't discussed that you'd like to add?
I could go on forever, really, couldn't I? Yeah, that's a good question to ask me. I think I might have liked to have been a politician. I think I would have loved to have been more active in a political party, but there's never been one that's actually fitted into my political head. I'm not a Labour Party person, I'm not a Plaid Cymru, I'm not a Conservative, I'm not a Liberal Democrat, I'm not a Socialist Worker, I'm a Georgina. And I think if we had the Georgina Party, then I'd be really happy in that one. That's about it.
Well, there's always time to start your own party.
Yeah.
It's another volunteering opportunity.
Yes, yes.
Okay, well, thank you.
Thank you very much. I've enjoyed talking to you ladies. Well done.
I've enjoyed talking to you too.
Thank you. Every success.